Hello? You want me to write some Python code to create Word documents? Right, okay. Yeah, leave it with me. Bye!
Okay, so here we go. Here's the code. So if you're on Linux, Mac OS X, or Windows, this should work for you. And you don't actually need Word installed. Potentially, you could even run this on a server, on a Raspberry Pi. You could run it anywhere, and you can generate Word files without needing to intervene. So what I'm going to show here is how to actually create the sections of the Word document. Much of this is taken from the official documentation. One modification I've done actually is here. I've changed centimeters because I'm in Europe, because of the metric system. In the US, you would, instead of import CM, you could just do jizz. There you go. So entirely up to you on where you're based. So I'll just put it back to centimeters because that's what my code works with. I've got IntelliSense VS Code here. So depending on what your editor is, you may or may not see suggestions. Document equals document. So I'm creating an instance of document class on this line. And the first thing I want to do is change the... I've added a header. In the official documentation, there is, I don't believe there is a header. So to add a header, we use this code, header underscore section equals document.sections 0. So the first section of the document is going to be the header, and section.header equals a header. And then we're going to say paragraph 0. The first paragraph is going to be having the text, which says header of document. This is where you can put your own header text. And by default, the font was coming through in some random font. So I've set it to be Calibri to match the rest of the document. So here we do set font, or rather we set the font using, so style equals document.styles and then normal, and style.font.name equals Calibri. So this to create the header, and this to set the font of the header. Right, next, to add the title, document dot add underscore heading. Simple as that. Next, add paragraphs. So if we add a paragraph of text, p is the variable name, which is equal to document dot add underscore paragraph. A plain paragraph having some stuff. Again, change your text here, whatever you want. This will all make sense when you see me run it in a minute or two, so hang in there. Don't forget to subscribe if you're getting distracted. p.add.run bold, so make it some bold text, add some more text. So that's bold, that won't be bold, and that will be italic. So fairly self-explanatory. Best thing to do is copy this code or download the, copy and paste even, the official example on the documentation. Document heading, paragraph, intense quote, gives you intense style of quote. Then we had some bullet points, list, and this bit here, we're adding a picture, so you need to specify the path to your image, and then this is the width of the image, and this is where I use the centimeters, CM. So if you can get a feel for it when you see it printed in a second, so we'll come on that. This is where we create a table, so three columns, and you can see what's going in the first row. Second row, third row. Again, we could put variables in here, and that's probably what I will do in a future video. Table equals document.addTable, so that's adding the table. Rows 1, columns equals 3. And this is where we will add the text down here in a minute. So I'm just going to comment all this. One thing VS Code picked up on was I had the example says ID and it didn't like using ID there, but IDX. Page break, up to you. Document. In fact, that doesn't need to be there, that line, I don't think. The only bit I've kind of skipped over here was the cells. So table rows dot cells. So the first table is going to have quantity, ID, and description is the title of each column. And then you do table dot add row, and then you add the cells. So this is quite specific syntax. Just run it, modify it, and break it. And there is some bit missing here because I'm not saving it. Okay, so we're back. And yeah, it was document.save. I think I had the little linting error there because I hadn't added the new line at the end, which the linter always complains about. So yeah, here we go. So let's run it. We've got, I just want to show you, this is my image. So this is the image that we intend to insert into the finished Word document. So without further ado, I've just come out of Zen mode and we've just got ready to run it. So let's just press the play button, code runner, to run it within VS Code. You can use idle, Sublime Text, whatever, makes no difference. You'll still get something which looks like open containing folder, demo.docx. I'm opening it with LibreOffice, but if you open it with Word, it should look pretty much the same. And you'll just notice there, the header is Calibri. If I hadn't set that in the code, then it would have been some other font. So here we can see, you can just cross-reference these with what I had in the Python code. So if we go back there, close that and bring up the code. Yeah, if we just look, we can just kind of look across, you can see the header and the font. So that was set there. This is the document title. So document.addHeading, that's there. And the paragraph, plain paragraph. Bold. So bold is the word there, you see in the red quotes there. So it's all fairly self-explanatory. That, if you click on it and just get the properties, you will see that it's 5 centimeters wide. If you're working in inches, that will obviously show you what it is in inches. And yeah, the little table here, so you've got quantity, ID, description. So this would be perfect for creating some sort of automated invoice in Word. And then if you like, you could then convert it to a PDF and then send it to a customer. So yeah, it doesn't look that pretty in VS in LibreOffice, but if we do print preview, yeah, that looks better, doesn't it? So there you go. There's a Word document which you can customize until your heart is content. So if this is just the way that you want to do it and create the document from scratch, do it this way. Alternatively, I'll put the link up to my other video where you can use a template. So this is kind of a quick and it's a quick way of doing it without needing a template. There's pros and cons for doing both methods. I think potentially you've got more work to do here because you're actually creating everything from scratch. And this, the only drawback of doing it this way is to put in a hyperlink is hard work. So potentially if you want to put in hyperlinks, you'll be better off doing it as per my other video. But if you want to do generate a Word document from scratch without using a template, then this is obviously the way to